feeling stuck with marketing strategies that just aren't delivering results, or perhaps you're not even sure how those strategies are actually performing. Well, the attribution reports in Amplitude may just be the game changer that you're looking for. In this video, we'll uncover what makes Amplitude's attribution so powerful to help you track complex journeys, gain actionable insights, and unlock maximum return on investment. Let's jump right in. As always, this video comes from a request from a client. They wanted to use Amplitude for attribution. This is typically something that Google Analytics has had a monopoly for a very long time. But today in 2025, there's lots of tools of doing this. Amplitude is just another one. And actually, their way of showing attribution, either by last touch, first touch, data-driven models, and a few others, is actually quite powerful. So I want to show you how you actually set it up, how you use it, and all the things you can do with it. So the first thing we need is a feature called channels. Now channels is actually right here in the left-hand side data. And if you go to properties, you're gonna have, of course, event properties, user properties, and then you have a tab called channels. So channels is a way to create groupings. Now Google Analytics, for example, which is what sort of popularized attribution on web at the very least, they kind of do this for you behind the scenes. So you may be familiar with many of these groupings, things like social, organic, paid, and so on. So Google Analytics actually has this table, a documentation somewhere that shows you the different logic they do to categorize traffic based on UTMs, whether it's UTM source or UTM medium. The powerful thing here in Amplitude for channels is you can create your own channels. You can create multiple channels. So of course I have clients who may have channels for just paid media or perhaps channels for different products. So when you open channels, you have this table here and you can choose the properties that you'll be using to identify or group channels. In this case, we can use UTM source as a primary one. And then when we add the first row, you know, we're saying that any user who comes in with a UTM source of CPC, PPC, paid search, or Bing will be categorized as paid search. Then the second row says if they come in with IG or FB, both for Facebook or Meta today, they'll be categorized as paid social. And then we kind of keep going down. The important thing to know here is this is a cascading logic, which means that the number one row is the most important one. This is already the first one users are checked against. If users do not match this row, then they go on to the second row, and then the third row, and the fourth row, and so forth. This is important because, of course, today, you know, multi-touch is very common. So users may be coming in with different UTM sources or UTM mediums. So you want to identify how you want to organize this. Now, depending on what model you use, of course, this will vary. But generally speaking, put your most important channels at the very top and the least important ones at the very bottom. The UTM source here is, of course, flexible. This is basically any user property you have available in your Amplitude account, which means it's very, very powerful, right? Because, you know, for UTM source, for example, we, of course, have our last touch UTM source. We can use our first touch UTM source. We could perhaps pass custom things that we may have. So lots of flexibility here, especially compared to something like Google Analytics where you don't have this kind of flexibility. The second thing that might be relevant here is you might have a second column like I do here called refer. And here simply what we're doing is trying to track traffic that may not have a UTM. The most common example here is of course organic search where you're being referred from Google or Yahoo or Bing and there are no UTMs, but we do have the refer domain. So down here, you can see that we first tag or categorize all the UTM sources. And then once we don't have UTM sources, or basically you know, once there's nothing left, then we actually move on to refer. And then we're saying, you know, if they come from Google, if they come from Yahoo or Bing or Microsoft, or if they come from organic social like LinkedIn, Instagram, and so on, then we're going to categorize them this way. And of course, you can see the sort of catch holes here where, you know, if there are UTM sources that we haven't categorized here, then we'll catch them in this any, and we'll call it other ads. And if there are referrers that we haven't categorized here, then we'll catch them and just call them like some kind of external referral. And then for everything else, we'll just call it direct. Now you can have as many rows as you want here. You know, I built channels that may have 50, 80 rows where we have very specific logic where we're saying, if the last touch is this, do this. If the first touch is this, do that. And we, you know, we'd be talking about last touch UTM source, first touch UTM source. So building a channel, very powerful, very easy to do. And of course you can tweak this at any time, you can move around. So this is the very first step. Next, to view attribution, we're gonna use the data tables report. This is just a basic table structure. There's a couple ways we can do it, but This is, I think, the easiest way. So in here, we can just add our conversion events. Let's say we want to add something like a trial started. We'll keep it simple. So right away, we get a number of unique trial starters over the last 30 days. In the grouping, we can then come in and add our channels, right? Remember, we call it add channel grouping. And then Amplitude right away will do this logic based on the channels. Now, this is not quite attribution. Amplitude in this case, it really is just using the channel grouping logic and then trying to break it out based on that. There is another level, which is just attribution itself. So if we add this, then we can change the attribution model and we can take something like a last touch. And if you highlight, it kind of tells you how the credit is being given here. Of course, 100% to the last touch, or in the first touch model, there's 100% there. And then we'll do the last touch for now. And then we can see the numbers shift slightly. So again, attribution, remember, is not a 100% science. It varies depending on what model you use. If we switch this to something like a first touch, of course, the numbers will change again. If we try that. And you can see actually more channels came in. Now, the value here, of course, is that it's still based on channel grouping. So we have some flexibility in how this attribution model is working to some extent. We can play around with different models in just a couple clicks. We can refresh the data. We can see how different things break out. There is a data-driven model, which I'm always particularly interested in because this tends to use a form of machine learning. Google Analytics also has it. But this in itself makes your attribution very, very flexible. As long as your data makes sense in Amplitude, you're tracking the specific properties that you're using to make all of this happen, specifically the properties we use in the channels, then you can play around with different attribution models and get a sense as to how different channels are actually contributing to driving this specific conversion. Of course, we can keep adding conversion events here, 3, 4, 5, whatever number it is, and then run them through the same attribution model or actually different attribution models, though that may not make as much sense. This is a great overview, pretty equivalent to what you might get in Google Analytics, except, of course, it's much more flexible. Anything you have available in Amplitude is going to be here. You can filter down. You can create special user segments, cohorts, all that kind of stuff. The final thing I'll mention is the channels groupings you create can actually be used in other reports. For example, this is the segmentation report in Amplitude. We see, of course, a number of trials started on a daily breakdown, but we can actually group this here by the user property, specifically those groupings we created. And now the same chart gets broken out. Now, if you remember, this was the original breakdown without an attribution model. So attribution is not going to be available here, but you can still use the channel groupings to understand how things are trending, how things look like from a conversion perspective. You can take this into a funnel, of course. You can take this into cohorts, retention, and it gives you a great sense of how different groups of channels actually convert against your other metrics in Amplitude. Again, very flexible because all the reports you may have in Amplitude, you can then break them out by your channel grouping with a basic attribution model, not last touch or first touch. But nonetheless, it gives you a sense as to how things are actually looking across your key metrics. And that is all I have for today. My name is Ruben Garta. I'm an expert in MarTech. This is one of the many use cases I help clients with. If you ever wonder why users are dropping off in your product or just struggle to understand what's going on inside your product, you should definitely check out this next video. I recorded a short tutorial on how to enable session replay inside Amplitude. This is something that historically has only been available in Hotjar or Full Story, and now Amplitude has it, and it's very convenient to access all within the same Amplitude data. I'll walk you through 3 simple steps to really uncover exactly what's going on inside your product, view this video-like replays of what users are doing, and then from there, find insights to be able to improve your product. So the video will be here, and I highly recommend you watch that next. Until next time, talk soon.